open source software, such as Wikipedia, we can use it to contribute to online information. Today on Intertech, we talk to guys who produce open source hardware. They use it to collect worldwide data on the declining bee population.
Welcome, Aaron and Tristan. So for dummies, what do you exactly do?
Okay, we recognize that we live in a time where there are a lot of global issues, and we're working in these new paradigms where people realize we can use the power of the internet to work together to solve our common problems. And in this specific case, we're working on bee decline. So we recognize that bees and their populations are starting to dwindle, and we want to study that through global networks of scientists, but not official academic scientists, more like citizens working together to study the problem. So we're taking sensors and we're putting them inside beehives, and we're streaming data about the hives to the internet so anybody can look at the issue and try and understand what's causing the problem.
So open source hardware makes it possible for everyone to just download a personal beehive for free?
It means that anyone can download the file which you can use to make your personal beehive. We live in a world that often people treat things like their design time and their intellectual property as something which should be exclusive to them or to paying customers. Open source hardware is different in the sense that it allows people to share designs and make things for themselves more easily. And in the process, if you're focusing on solving a problem, it means that more people are able to help you solve that problem and access the tools to solve that problem in their own local environment.
Okay, and why is it so important to collect data worldwide on an amateur scale?
Well, we found that anytime you have a lot of power and authority centralized, that central body is not always responsible to the people that are it's supposed to serve. There's a lot of corruption that can happen when things are consolidated. So instead, what we want to do is create these decentralized networks where nobody owns anything and the data is available to everyone and everyone can participate. And so we think that we'll have higher fidelity within the data itself. It's more democratic and it's more trustworthy in the long run.
Thanks so much, guys, for sharing your knowledge on what you do. And if you want to know more about this topic, go to interconnection.com.